Well, hi there, ladies and gentlemen. But you'll see here that I have a very advanced studio microphone setup, and today we're going to be taking a look at how I installed a system of subwoofers, amp, and all that good stuff into a 2003 Pontiac Grand Am GT Ram Air with some difficulty, and how I'm going to show you how you can bypass these difficulties. So in this first picture, you'll just see my amp and a bunch of sloppy wiring. That's because I haven't necessarily cleaned it up yet, because I accomplished it just a few moments ago. And then you'll see some pictures of 6x9s, because I was trying to install it using an LOC, so I could just use the stock head unit. So I used a line output converter to take the low power of the stock and convert it to high power, or RCA outputs, for my subwoofers and the amplifier that I have for my subwoofers, which is a Lanzar Vibe 800 watt 4 channel. And see, the problem with I found this out by reading online forums, and by my own difficulties in trying to do this, that the converter or the amplifier of the stock system in Pontiacs, or maybe it's just Grand Ams, but I know Pontiac Grand Ams in general, they have a Monsoon system, which is a very decent stock system, I must say. But you can't use your rear speakers, because the amplifier sends a different signal to each speaker, which is kind of difficult, because you need the same left right. You can't have a different signal altogether to each speaker. They need to be connected to be able to work for it to work. So you'll see here my failed attempt at trying to get a signal from my 6x9s in the back. You'll see that on the slides of my splice connectors on those, and a little bit of speaker wire that's still hanging from them, because I didn't successfully get it in there. I didn't get a signal from them because they had a different conflicting signal. Zip that up a little bit for you people, because you don't want to be looking at me. So that would be a line out converter. Those are my subs. And then eventually you'll come to a picture where you see a little Monsoon logo in the back. That would be the edge of the stock amplifier. And then there's like something like 18 or 20 wires come out of this thing for each speaker. There's like 6 stock tweeters and like 4 speakers and 6x9s. It's a pretty nice stock system. But this Monsoon system, I had to tap into the lineouts for the stock subwoofers, even though there isn't any. So I don't know where those were going to in the first place, but I found a wiring diagram, which I'll also show you for this specific system. And I just mashed those to the right lineouts for the RCA convert, the high-low converter I had, the LOC. And then, boom, threw it into my amp, connected it all. I'm assuming that if you guys didn't do this already, basically what you need to do if you're having trouble installing in a Pontiac or any kind of car that has a Monsoon or Bose system, they have really powerful stock amps that will send separate signals to each speaker, so you won't be able to do it because it will be a conflicting signal. What you are going to need to do is find the stock amplifier, use the wiring diagram that I have provided for you. Here, take a screenshot or email me or something, and I'll just take a screenshot, print screen, not that hard. And then use that, or you can just search one on Google, use that, and then you can wire it up correctly to your line-out converter, plug your line-out converter into your amps, and voila, you have success. So that's all I really wanted to tell you guys, just a little bit of a tutorial type thing on how to install speakers properly. But so if this helped you out, go ahead and tell me what go ahead and show a video of what your speakers or system sounds like, in your Pontiac or your Bose system. I think all GM cars have either a Monsoon or a Bose from this era, because my mom has a Chevy Trailblazer 2004, and that has a Bose system in it, which has about the same type of setup, just a little bit bigger because it's an SUV and not a just a little Grand Am. But yeah, so if you have any questions, go ahead and leave them down below. And the wires that I used were, I know that they're like the last four in the wiring diagram. Let's see here, I used F12 through F16, or no, F13 through F16. So the light blue black is the right subwoofer speaker output negative, and they alternate from there down. So yeah, go ahead and leave a comment. I'll show you the wiring diagram for both my stock system and for the Monsoon system and for the line-out converter that I had, so you guys can make it real easy for you. And I already told you what you needed, so yeah. Just so you can avoid confusion, don't tap into the 6x9s like you normally would, but tap into the outs on the amplifier. That's it. Have a good day.